the upside down nature of what Jesus talked about when he was on the earth. So, before we do that, have a look at these pictures here. Can anybody tell me what is the common theme between these four pictures? Pardon? They're all what? They're all bright. They're all green. They're all green. So we've got the queen, we've got Game of Thrones, you can see because that's an 18. But you might know something about it, because it's quite a big show at the moment. We've got Lord of the Rings, which is a bit old now, but hopefully you'll wear it. And then we've got Shrek. Yes. Oh, that's very close. They've all got leaders. Yeah, yeah. They all have links to royalty, that's very close as well. That's pretty much it, really.
Yes.
They all, yeah, they're all things to do with kings and queens. You pretty much got it. What were you going to say, Liam? Yeah, that as well. So the link is they all live in or are part of kingdoms. Okay. So a kingdom is something that has a ruler, a king, or a queen. So the queen obviously is the queen of the United Kingdom. That's the time, isn't it? Game of Thrones is all about a kingdom, seven kingdoms that have come together. Apparently, I'm mentioning it. Lord of the Rings is all about the kingdom of men and the kingdom of elves and the kingdom of dwarves and the kingdom of Mordor. And Shrek is all about the kingdom of far, far away. So, kingdoms are a really common theme in stories and in books and in films and stuff. And even in real life, we have experience of kingdoms. When Jesus was on the earth 2,000 years ago, he talked a lot about the kingdom of God. Okay, so the kingdom of God is basically just a term for anywhere that God's rule and reign is happening. So any place where God is in charge, okay? And when Jesus was on the earth, loads of people started to say that he was the king, that people should follow him. And lots of people started to say as well, the kingdom of God has come from Jesus, right? So let's have a quick think about some of the ways that God's kingdom is an unusual kingdom. There's lots of kingdoms, but a kingdom has like certain rules and certain values often made by the king or the queen about how people should behave, about what's important and that kind of thing. So normally, in most kingdoms, the way to succeed or get to the top is to succeed, right? It's to be great, it's to be good, it's to be a winner, it's to do stuff right. And it's to be first, to get there first, to be the best. Well, Jesus actually said that it wasn't actually about that. And he said that actually if you were last, if you were last, that actually that was the best thing to be. The best thing to be was to be humble and to be a servant and to put other people first. Because if you were last, if you put yourself last, that actually God would say that you were in fact first. That he turned it upside down, that the last shall be first. And I think that's really cool, that's amazing. Because that's not the way that the world ever does it. And that's not the way that lots of kingdoms that we experience have their values set up. Another thing which Jesus talked about, which I think is amazingly powerful, really incredible, is that we're not defined by our failures. Often we can label people as a bit of a loser or a bit of a failure, and actually the way to get ahead, the way to be the best is to be a winner. And that failure is a really negative, bad thing. Now, obviously we don't set out in life to fail, but Jesus actually taught that the failures in your life are not the end of you, they're not what define you. Because Jesus said that your failure can be forgiven, it can be turned upside down. And what seems like a mess can be turned into a success. And when you've got problems and issues and challenges and you feel like a failure, that actually there's hope. Because Jesus wants to forgive that stuff. Another thing, if people want to have it all together, they want to have a purpose, they want to know where they're going. And sometimes you can think, oh, I'm a bit lost. I don't know where I'm going. I don't know where I'm headed. Anybody ever feel like that? I'm a bit confused. I don't know what the future holds. I don't know what I should do. Oh, I don't know anything. I just feel a bit lost. Jesus said that actually, if you're lost, you can turn out upside down, you can be found. You can be lost. You can be a part of God's family, you can be a part of people. You don't feel like you're lost, but you feel like you're a bit lost, a bit directionless. But actually, you can be found. How amazing is that? One of the words that people used back in the day, it's kind of gone a bit out of fashion now, but you might have heard it, is the word sinner. And people were often, in Jesus' day, when he was on the earth 2,000 years ago, people were often labeled as sinners by the bad stuff they've done. Basically, sin is just anything we do which doesn't live up to God's standards. If God's real and he's got a kingdom, anything where we're selfish, where we do what we want, where we hurt other people, all the negative stuff, you know, lies and cheating and gossip, all that stuff that messes up our lives, people are often labeled as sinners. And the reality is, all of us actually are sinners. We all fall short of perfect standards, don't we? We all get stuff wrong, yeah? Well, how amazing would it be if rather than being called a sinner, we could, that could be turned upside down and we could be called saints? How imagine that way. If you could become St. Helena, if you could become St. Helena, if you could become St. John, you might have seen statues and pictures of like St. Peter or St. Paul. But you know what? Jesus taught that actually anybody can become a saint if they accept him. Because it's not about what you've done or what you can do. It's about what God has done for you. And that actually, he can see you as a saint because of the forgiveness that he offers you. And the reason for that is this next upside down thing. And that is that death, being dead is kind of the ultimate end, right? And that's like, we're dead, and that's it, right? But Jesus' followers, you might know this bit of the story, it's pretty famous, they claim that actually Jesus had even conquered death. That he turned death upside down by coming back to life. That he'd come alive, and that death had been defeated and conquered. And because of that, in doing that, he took the penalty and the punishment for all of our sin, all of our failure, all of our losses, all the stuff that we need sorting out in our lives. That he dealt with all that so that we can be forgiven, so that we can have hope, so that we're not trapped in despair. So that we can be alive as well, so that actually death isn't the end, doesn't need to be the end of our stories. But actually there's hope of a life after death for each one of us, because that's true. How amazing is that? And if you ever feel a bit lost, if you ever feel like a failure, if you ever feel a bit left out, if you ever feel like you're a sinner, like you've done stuff wrong, that stuff doesn't define you. That's not the end of you. But actually the invitation that Jesus gives to each one of us is to be part of his kingdom. Not by being good, not by having the right qualifications, not by attending the right events, even going to church or anything like that, just simply by accepting him. By accepting his offer of forgiveness and freedom. He says that you can become a citizen of his kingdom. You can be part of the kingdom of God. How amazing is that? If that's true, that is a total life changer. So, I just want to leave that thought with you, that God's kingdom is an upside down kingdom. There's all kinds of stuff that Jesus talks about. Think about the last one first. He talks about to get rich and to give stuff away. Think about loving your enemy. He talks about all those things that are opposite to how the world often does. But one of the key things that he talks about is how our sin, our losses, and our failure doesn't have to define us. So that can be turned upside down. And then death can come to life. And not just physically, but spiritually, when death can come alive. And all of us can have eternal life. So I'd love to just finish by praying, if that's okay. And if you're if that's something new to you, if you're not really sure about that, it's just talking to God, really. And if you would call yourself a Christian, then you can join in and say, oh, amen again, if you want, which means sort of I agree with that. And if you don't yet believe in God, you can just listen to what I say and think about it for yourself. Maybe you want to kind of echo it in your own heart and talk to God for the first time. Perhaps you want to have a chat to one of the leaders or one of your friends about what is this whole kingdom of God thing? Who is Jesus God? What's the big deal about it? What difference is it make? And check it out for yourself. So let's just spend a minute praying together.